My name's Ollie Turnsaw and I play Carl Gallagher from Shameless.
My name's Ollie Turnsaw and I play Dan from Emmerdale.
And we're just showing our support for Kevin Williams.
Craig Hignett has the run of the midfield. Anthony Hutton on halfway. Already been heavily involved, Hutton gets a little kick there, a little welcome to the game from Ben Malpas. Ball goes long and comfortably back to the Hill Street Heroes goalkeeper, John Johnson, sharing a name with one of the Borough youngsters in the first team a couple of times last season. Here come the Hill Street Heroes. Square ball is on. Instead it goes all the way back to the midfield. They've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blue shirts attacking. The ball's going to bounce away. I think they're going to get a corner, and the Hill Street Heroes will get the first corner of the afternoon here. We've had just in and around 15 minutes, I think. Closer to 10. Corner kick then to the Heroes. It's going to be taken right-footed by number 25, Wayne Rayner. Works for a hairdresser's. And he cuts the ball into the area now. Genius. See what I did there? Cleared away. Matt Bailey now can bring it away. Good running from Bailey. Plenty of physical ability. Look at him go down the line. He wants it played to him. And now Matt Bailey will get it. 10,000 people watching the TFM radio breakfast producer. He's laid the ball off superbly. Oh, and he tried the return to Bailey then. It was great football, but it just didn't come off. Stephen Nicholas, it was, of Dream Team, tried to slot the ball back there. But Matt Bailey hadn't made the return run, and that was unfortunate. A great break from Bailey, though. And he was so close to getting an opportunity maybe to double the lead of the TFM Radio All-Stars, who currently lead by 1-0. The one goal scored by Dan Gillings, right-footed strike, after a free kick was laid into his path just inside the penalty area. Really strong defending from Glenn Lamont, and he and Curtis Fleming look almost unbeatable as a back two. Craig Hignett now, for once, fails to use the ball well, Higgy. And it's one off him. That's a super ball threaded down the right-hand side toward number 10, Michael Roberts. Roberts, level with the edge of the box, pulls it back. It's a great cross. The shot hit Fleming's head, and then he gets underneath the ball. So unfortunate there, Nick Hamlin. A good piece of running. It was a decent strike as well, the first one, but Fleming blocked it. Second time round, it was like an up and under, and Gary Phillipson comfortably catching the ball. Gary Phillipson's beginning to bark out some orders now, suddenly thinking maybe that he could have been a professional after his show early on. Offside flag is up, and much to the frustration of the TFM All-Stars bench, as Courage the Cat, the mascot, makes his way around the edge of the field with a few of the TFM radio team down there as well. Can spot Katie and Dawn from the TFM charity department, who've done so much hard work to get this game on this afternoon. And what a great success it looks already. Sure, it's going to raise absolutely loads of money for Cash for Kids, and that's why we're all here. The 11 in blue are here to get a result as well, and it's Michael Roberts now, edge of the box, lays it into the centre, heavy touch, goes behind, and Curtis Fleming could just watch that happen then. Couple of nerves maybe in the centre. It was Nick Hamlin who had the opportunity to turn on the ball in the box, but he didn't quite take his time as much as he could, and in the end the ball went out of play for a goal kick to the TFM All-Stars. Down the right-hand side, Heroes inside the area, super little turn, real chance to equalise, unselfish play, and it's over the bar. What an opportunity. Michael Roberts did all the legwork, laid it back to the penalty spot, and how on earth he managed to put it over, I'm not sure, but Nick Hamlin had his head in his hands then. It was a great chance to equalise, and the first substitutions are about to be made. I can see Rocky Andrews from The Apprentice, owner of Fatso's Filling Stations. A couple of TFM radio DJs look like they might be about to get into the action as well, or they're warming up. I wonder if that means they're coming on right now. They're a motley crew, these celebrities, I can tell you. Anthony Hutton from Big Brother is going off, and there's a group of about 20 screaming girls who are looking for his autograph then, but he's besmirched them, he's ignored them, he's off. I'm sure he'll be back. A few high fives from the All-Stars team, and I'm now going to try and keep up. Here's Wayne Allen. Oh, he's thundered into a challenge. Allen has been in the game for about 10 seconds, and he's already in the thick of it. The referee's had to tell him to calm down. Wayne Allen, the bad boy of the TFM Radio All-Stars team, perhaps. Who knows? And now on the right-hand side, it could be a chance. Inside the area, what a save by the goalkeeper. Needs to get rid. Does get rid. And John Johnson got down terrifically well there. Shot from just inside the area. I think it was from Danny Miller. That's Aaron Dingle from Emmerdale. Great effort from him as well, but what a save. Here he is again. Dingle chips it into the area. Too long, all the way back to the goalkeeper. I do apologise if sometimes these celebrities get referred to by their actor names rather than their actual names, but it's just a little bit easier. So now it's a tiny little figure running away. Excellent bit of play. I'm not sure who that celebrity is. I'm just going to find out. It's Colin Harris from the Damned United as the long ball goes in toward the area. It's almost headed over the top of the keeper. Worrying moment there for 24. That's John Paul Thomas, but he just managed to nod the ball back to his goalkeeper, John Johnson. Certainly looks the part. Wayne Allen has gone for the traditional black boots. I like to see that. None of this red nonsense. Nothing too flashy. And there certainly wasn't anything flashy about his first 30 seconds in the game when he piled into his man. He's just given an underarm throw. And he's been told by a couple of the celebrities that that's not really how it works. Wayne Allen. And there was no surprise, no reaction from the crowd. He punches the air. Wayne Allen does not look like he's played football before in his life. Gary Phillipson has been terrific so far. Possibly the best player on the pitch. Great bit of goalkeeping. Saw the danger. Came out and cleared it. Well done to the presenter of Late Night Zoo. Fantastic. Gary Phillipson has the ball. Gives a little wave to the crowd. He wants a change. Gary Phillipson's in trouble. He's holding the back of his hamstring. Well, this is a worrying moment. I'm not sure they've got a reserve goalkeeper. He's waving furiously to the bench. At the minute, he's being ignored. Well, that could be very, very costly for the All-Stars team. The Heroes have got to get back on the ball if they're going to take advantage. Long ball downfield. Oh, the All-Stars are in. Must be 2-0. Bearing down on goal. Oh, he's wide. What a miss. Colin Harris, John McGovern of the Damned United. He is a tiny little figure, is Harris. I thought maybe he was an extra from Lord of the Rings at first. He's not. And he should have scored there. Right-footed. Beat the goalkeeper all ends up, but just slotted it wide of the post. The gloves are off, and who's going to go in goal? Well, it looks like the giant figure of Rav Francis. That is, if you remember before, the stunt coordinator from Emmerdale. And a great reception for Gary Phillipson. And that looks like a foul on halfway. Indeed it is. Almost got away with it there. Did number 17. And that is Rocky Andrews. And that's the first time he's been anywhere near the ball. Left-hand side. Back toward the edge of the area. That's good defending, though, from the Hill Street Heroes. Should be able to clear the ball. Gets a deflection. And it will be a throw-in for the local lads team, the Hill Street Heroes, level with the edge of their own penalty area. TFM Radio's charity, Cash for Kids, is the reason we're all here, of course. 29 minutes gone now at the Riverside Stadium. Big thank you to Steve Gibson and everyone at Middlesbrough Football Club for allowing the stadium to be used for this purpose. It's certainly seen a very, very good attendance as the offside flag goes up. In any case, the ball is very smartly stabbed into the back of the net by Danny Miller, Aaron Dingle from Emmerdale. Hill Street Heroes, 35 yards from goal. Clipped in toward Roberts on the edge of the box, and he applauds the intent, if not the execution, because in the end it went all the way back to stunt coordinator Rav Francis. So the TFM Radio All-Stars can continue. They've got a corner into the area. It comes. Oh, it was almost a free header, but again the goalkeeper John Johnson was out very, very quickly to make sure he could grab the ball. The substitutions are about to be made. Elliot Tittensaw has made his way off the field. Just like saying his name. Matt Bailey from The Breakfast Show is one of the players who's going to come on in a moment. Wasn't very happy with the allocation of the number 24. And he wouldn't have been happy with his performance so far, perhaps. Craig Hignett is back on the pitch. One of the celebrity players, former players, that everyone's come to see. And the Heroes are in trouble here. A free opportunity to shoot. Edge of the area. It's beautifully worked. No offside flag. 2-0. And I think it's Anthony Hutton that got the goal. Indeed it is, the winner of Big Brother 6, finding the back of the net. It was an open goal, he could scarcely miss, and the fans cheer, but I'm not happy about a Newcastle fan scoring at the Riverside. It was the easiest of finishes. Craig Hignett has been back on the pitch for around about 2 minutes, and he cut open the Hill Street Heroes defence, and at 2-0 down, it is a long, long way back for the men in royal blue.
Hello, my name's Danny Miller. I play Aaron Dingle in Emmerdale, and I'm here to support TFM Radio's Cash for Kids.